My name is Mary Jo Ehrman, and I am the owner of Fiscal Bridge and the author of Farming Without the Bank and Wealth Without the Bank, or Wall Street. I got into the industry in 2010, shortly after the market crashed. I was a PNC agent, and I didn't like life insurance. I didn't want anything to do with life insurance, and came upon the concept, the infinite banking concept, in Nelson Nash's book, and thought, there is no possible way that this is legal. If this was legal, people would be doing it. Absolutely not. So I immersed myself in information. I read 5 books in 6 weeks, to the point where my daughter said, "Mommy, all you do is read." And I didn't leave the couch. I could not believe that all of this information was out there. And because I had searched forever during the market crash, because I didn't want my money in the market. Long story short, realized that it was a true concept. It was legit. So I just said, "Hey, you know what? I'm doing this. I'm going to tell the world. They have to know, because people are just out there hoping and praying for the best. And it's not hard information. So I'm going to share it. And I'm going to share it. I call it the Mary Jo way, with Mary Jo terminology, because it's very simple. I don't use any big fancy terms, because people don't understand that. I didn't understand it when I got into the industry. Why would I expect somebody else to understand it? So a few years of teaching the concept to everybody, I realized that this is extremely helpful to farmers, and they have lost all of their control to the banks. They need to get the control back. They're putting their livelihood up as collateral. That has to stop. We're losing family farms. We're buying the farm with every single generation from the bank. That has to stop. There's a way to stop it. And farmers didn't believe me. And corn was $7 a bushel. So they were using cash. Who cares? I don't need you. I got cash. And because I'm stubborn and they're stubborn, I wrote a book. And there's one thing that farmers do, and they read. And they do a lot of reading, and they like to read. And they're always educating themselves. So I wrote the book, Farming Without the Bank, to prove my point, and actually put numbers in there, put case studies in the book, so that they could see how it works. And here we are today, Farming Without the Bank.